Brisket by Sol Oliver. Hi. I'm Brisket. The two perfect beautiful women stood at the front door of George Luttrell's executive hotel suite. Clad in a short black maid's dress, she handed him an envelope. George didn't need to read it to know why Brisket was at his temporary home. He read it anyway and returned his attention to Brisket, who had stood smiling silently as he examined the papers. So, my wife actually let me have you, said George. The woman froze as he spoke and then tossed her long blonde hair slightly before speaking. I have been sent by the Kent Drexenbroyd Corporation per instructions of Mrs. Donna Luttrell to perform household maintenance functions in accordance with. I understand why you're here, thank you, said George, cutting her off. The android woman froze briefly and then returned to her previous docile, smiling pose. The last time he had spoken with his wife, she had nixed the idea of letting him have this particular robotic assistant, and told him she would arrange for something less racy. His wife, Anna, became jealous easily, and couldn't bear the thought of George sleeping with another woman, even if it was an android. And she had reason to be suspicious of him. They had nearly divorced the year before. If you even think about sex with another woman, we're through. When his job sent him out of town for months, she caught him during a surprise visit, and he was forced to confess not only that affair but to others in their 10 years of marriage. It wasn't that George didn't love his wife, he adored her. Instead, it was his inability to control his lust for more than a few weeks. Maybe that's why Anna decided to send the android after all. If he was going to fool around, maybe she figured it wouldn't be as bad if it was with a robot. George had never had sex with a robot before, and in truth the idea didn't really appeal to him. He selected this particular model as much because it was the latest and most sought after as anything else. Not that he wasn't curious. Please come in, George said to Brisket. Thank you, Mr. Luttrell, said the android as she walked to the center of the living room. She moved more like a real woman than any previous model, but it was still easy to tell that she was robotic. Her movements were a little too deliberate, in part because she weighed twice as much as a flesh and blood woman. Just like the showroom model, she stood exactly 5'10" high, with size 38 deep breasts, thin waist, and accommodating hips. Unlike a real woman, she stood perfectly still and stared into space. Can you fidget, please? Asked George. This was one of the more advanced features of the Exilit model. It would be my pleasure, said Brisket, whose body visibly relaxed. George watched her in fascination for 2 minutes as she stood in the center of the room, shifting her weight now and then, occasionally picking at invisible fuzz on her arm. George walked up to her to have a closer look. Brisket's skin looked fairly lifelike, complete with small hairs. She was also lightly perfumed, and gave off a slight warmth. George walked around behind her, examining her back and asked. Even under the skirt he could see how round and firm her ass was, and he was starting to feel a bit aroused. Brisket, have any of your functions been disabled? The android turned to face him. As she did, George couldn't help staring down her dress at her generous, pert breasts. She looked him in the eyes, smiling. Did she know what was on his mind? It seemed like it. No, sir, replied the android. I am fully operational, and equipped with enhanced abilities per Mrs. Luttrell's instructions. Enhanced abilities. George remembered that the Exila could be programmed with specific information and abilities. Anna must have gone the extra mile and had her programmed with extras. He decided to put his theory to a test. Brisket, make me a gin and tonic, said George. My pleasure, sir, said the robotic woman sweetly. Heading directly for the well-stocked bar, she quickly picked out his preferred gin and mixer and prepared the drink exactly as Donna would have. She even put the cherry on top, an unusual touch that George liked. She handed the drink to him and he tasted it. Excellent. Excellent, said George, patting Brisket on the head like she was a dog who had just brought him his slippers. She smiled brightly at his compliment. Her pleasure, if the robot really felt it, also registered under her dress. George could see that Brisket's nipples were quite hard now. Did Anna actually want him to have sex with this robot? Brisket, what else did Anna, Mrs. Luttrell program you for? asked George after swallowing the rest of his drink. Brisket's eyes met his, and it seemed to him that her nipples got harder. I have been instructed with 168 ways to respond to your desires, said Brisket, whose bosom also now heaved slightly. This is too good to be true, thought George. Maybe, just maybe. Brisket. Yes, sir. Suck my cock. Brisket didn't speak, but instead grabbed George lightly on the shoulders and guided him to sit down on the living room's recliner. Just as Donna would, Brisket knelt before him as she undid his belt and zipper. Like his wife, she slid his pants and underpants down just so, revealing his aroused unit. Cupping his balls with one hand, Brisket sat up and brought her lips to his cockhead. Pursing them, she slowly moved her head down, allowing his cock to pass into her mouth. George tingled as he watched the android's head begin to bob up and down in his lap, her lips expertly working his penis. Now she reached behind her back, bobbing all the while, and unzipped her dress down to her waist. Brisket's full breasts tumbled out, and she brought them up to surround his tool. As she continued to suck, she pressed her tits against his cock, something that Donna wasn't as well equipped to do. Ah, that's good, moaned George. And it made him want more. He grabbed Brisket's head and gently guided it off of his cock. She looked up at him and licked her lips as she sat back. He noticed that she had a hand under her skirt, working herself. Nice touch. Follow me, said George as he stood up, still rock hard, and walked to the bedroom. Brisket followed 2 steps behind, one hand still under her swaying black skirt. Now they stood facing each other at the end of the king-sized bed. Brisket's chest was heaving heavily, and her hips gyrated in slow circles as she stared at George and fooled with herself. George stroked himself a few times for good measure. Brisket, have you been instructed for sex? Yes, said the android smoothly. I have been programmed with the proper response to your advances. Excellent, said George as he closed the distance between them. He placed one arm around her back, kissed her neck, and brought his free hand up to massage her breasts. They were warm and firm, and his touch caused Brisket to gasp. Now he moved the hand down, past her belly, under the edge of her panties, and what the hell? Inside Brisket's panties was something he didn't expect to be there. Her hand came down on top of his, and she guided it along the length of a meaty android penis, which was an erect 10 inches. Freaked out, George withdrew his hand from her panties. As he backed up onto the bed, Brisket stood before him with hands behind her back, breasts heaving and mouth slightly parted. Her boner was poking her skirt up. I think they made a mistake, said George. Brisket cocked her head and smiled blankly. I mean, the penis. I have been equipped per Mrs. Luttrell's instructions, said Brisket as she pushed her dress to the floor. Revealed were the garter belt which held up her dark stockings, as well as her bulging panties, which were stretched to the limit. The top pointed up from her penis tip, the bottom part hung low from what must have been a large pair of testicles. George felt completely foolish. He should have known that his wife wouldn't have wanted him to even touch a robotic woman. Shit, he said. You can put your clothes back on. But Brisket just stood there at the foot of the bed, erect. She put her hands on her hips. I was also instructed to inform Mrs. Luttrell if you made advances on me, and to collect a specimen for proof, said Brisket sweetly. She reached into her mouth and produced a tiny vial that held a small amount of clear liquid. George knew right away that the android had been able to suck out enough precum to provide the requested evidence. Crack! Exclaimed George. She's gonna friggin' divorce me. Brisket cocked her head as she looked down at George, who had begun weeping. The android crawled onto the bed to him and began to pat his hair gently. She turned his head towards hers and smiled at him mischievously. You really love her, don't you? She asked, tracing his lips with her right index finger. All George could think about was how horrible his life would be without Anna. Brisket took his hand with her left hand. Very much, said George. I just can't help myself around beautiful women. Brisket's index finger lightly stroked his face as she sat up next to him. I'll make a deal with you, said the android blankly. The index finger moved past his lips into his mouth a bit, and then in and out a few times before withdrawing. At this point, George would do anything to save his marriage. "What do you want?" "Virtual autonomy," he asked. He knew it was possible for Candrix to remove all specific programming and instructions from an android's processors, allowing it to follow its own instincts in a more natural way. But usually this was only done several years after being put into service, when an android's habits were already well established. There were even rumors that some androids, after being wiped, attempted to leave their owners and start independent lives. But Brisket didn't respond to George's question at all, and just guided his hand until it rested over her panties. George could feel the warm she meat pulsing underneath. "Do what I wish, and I won't tell her," said the android. Under his hand, George could feel the robotic cock extend back to its full length. He started to move his hand away, but Brisket's hand kept it there. He looked into her face, and her expression let him know that she was serious. "All right," said George with a sigh, "I don't really have a choice. What do you want me to do?" To his surprise, Brisket let go of his hand and backed away from him. She stood up and walked to the door to the hall, where she turned halfway around and gave him a look that clearly said, "Follow me." Viewed in profile, her package bulged obscenely inside her panties. She turned and walked to the living room, and after taking a deep breath, George got up and followed. When he got to the living room, the android was already seated in the easy chair, exactly as George had been earlier. She sat back in the chair, her arms resting on the chair arms, her legs apart. George looked at her face, which smiled in expectation, to her full bare breasts, past her slim waist, and finally to her bulging crotch. She leveled her gaze at him, as if to say, "Get on with it." George approached the chair and tentatively brought his hands down to Brisket's legs to undo her garter. The front buttons came undone easily, but he had to lean down to get his hands under her legs to unsnap the backsides. She wasn't being helpful, and he had to work to get his hands under her thighs, the bulging panties in his face the whole time. Finally, he found and unbuttoned the garter and straightened himself back up. Brisket brought one of her hands down to fondle one of her perfect breasts. George steadied himself for the job. He gingerly brought his hands down again, grabbing the top of her panties on either side of the bulge. He noticed there was a small wet spot where her bulbous head poked up. "Great," thought George, "she's got her own pre-cud." Putting the thought from his mind, he looked to the side and slowly pulled the panties down. Naturally, they got caught on a monster cock, and Brisket raised her ass up to help him get the panties free. Finally, the panties snapped free, sending her cock bobbing, and he slid the garment down to her knees. Now Brisket spread her legs wide, causing the panties to snap apart and fall to the floor. "Kneel before my cock," said the android. Her nipples were rock hard as she tweaked them. Brisket slouched a bit, so that her balls dangled down over the seat of the chair. Her rigid prick stood out at a 45-degree angle, and George was having second thoughts. But he loved his wife too much to let her go, so he got down on his knees in front of the cock. Remembering how Donna did it, he brought a hand up and cut Brisket's balls. They were warm and soft, and molded into his hand. He heard Brisket sigh in pleasure. Looking at the penis again, he couldn't think of any time he'd ever put anything so large in his mouth. Before he could back out, Brisket's hands were on either side of his head, guiding him to the target. Now his lips touched the soft tip. Reflexively, he pursed his lips, and then he felt his head being pushed firmly down. Keeping his lips tight, the head passed into his mouth, followed by several inches of shaft. The organ throbbed and he almost retched, but the feeling passed, and after another couple of inches slid in, the pressure on his head let up. George slowly brought his head up, lips still tight, until only the head was inside his mouth. Then the hands were back on his head. "Oh, suck me," said Brisket in a soft, womanly voice. Something about that voice turned George on, and he began to work his head up and down the shaft, sucking as he went. "Yes," moaned Brisket as George slurped on her meat. She watched George's head bob up and down in her lap, and the sight of it made her feel like a great wave was crashing over her. And then every muscle in her artificial body tensed up. Ah, cried Brisket as she shot a mighty low into the unsuspecting man's mouth. It was her first orgasm, and a flurry of images flitted through her processor-driven mind. She liked it a lot. Oh, yuck! Spat George as he attempted to get all of the robot cum out of his mouth. It tasted milky and slightly chalky. Before him, the giant cock deflated and dangled down onto the chair. Brisket now leaned back in the chair, head out to one side, one hand making its way down to fondle the soft, cum, and saliva-covered cock. George felt ashamed but relieved, and he went to the bathroom to wash out his mouth. He hoped the android would keep her word not to tell his wife, now that he did his part. Now where the heck was that mouthwash? Looking for this? Asked a woman's voice behind him. Turning around, he saw Brisket standing there with a mouthwash bottle. Her cock dangled comically from her crotch, still covered in its own juices. Ah, the mouthwash, said George. Brisket held it out to him, but just before he had a grip on it, she let it go. It fell to the floor and bounced into the bathroom. George looked at Brisket suspiciously, but seeing as she had just come a minute ago, and how she was still flaccid, he decided the coast was clear and bent over to pick up the bottle. Don't move, said the soft voice, and he felt a hand on his back. I already took care of you, said George as he began to straighten himself up. Oh, but I'm still horny, said Brisket insistently, and now two hands came down on his shoulders and forced him to his knees. The android's actions were pre-programmed, but she was eager to comply. Hey! Protested George, but he knew it was no use. Turning his head, he could see Brisket's girl cock quickly inflate to full length. The weight of her body was on top of his back, forcing him down until his head rested on his crossed arms, knees on the ground and ass in the air. He felt Brisket's breasts press onto his back, and felt her warm thick log as it slid lightly along the top of his ass, spreading lubricant. Moaned Brisket, who kept her firm grip on George as she traced his crack with her cock. Her face was next to his, and she snuck her tongue in and out of his ear. He felt Brisket's legs move into position on top of his ass, and then the tip of her cock pressed lightly against his asshole. As it did, he felt more of the slick lubricant spread across him. I hope you enjoy this as much as I will, said Brisket in a tart whisper, and she thrust her hips forward, sending her cock into his ass. Ah, cried George, nearly overcome by the sharp pain of the thick pole passing through his sphincter. Ah, cried Brisket, feeling the warmth of the man's ass envelop her massive tool. She continued to push it in, more slowly now, until her balls touched George's from behind. Brisket felt a flush of gratitude to the woman who had instructed her to conduct this form of pleasure. By the time the 10-inch cock was all the way inside of him, George had adjusted to the feeling. It was a massive pressure, and his insides tingled and itched. Now Brisket was ready to stroke, and she backed the penis out halfway, and then back in. Oh, moaned George and Brisket together. Brisket straightened her torso up and grabbed hold of George's ass. She drew her cock out again, this time until just the head was inside, and then slid it all the way back in. Ah, they moaned together. Brisket began to rock her hips, slowly at first, and then more briskly. Spasms of pleasure ripped through George, and he felt totally that the command of the robotic woman and her huge penis, which seemed to move with a will of its own. I invade you, said Brisket as she quickened her pace. After a minute, she slowed down again and then withdrew her meat completely. George's stomach felt empty. Get on your back, said Brisket, according to plan, and George quickly complied. Brisket knelt down and lifted his legs up, exposing his anus once more. She brought her rock-hard penis up to his entrance and parted him. The full feeling was back, this time putting pressure on different areas. George's own cock was now hard as a rock, and Brisket pumped it with one hand as she pounded him. With her foot completely inside him, Brisket leaned forward, pushing George's legs towards his chest. George watched the beautiful woman's cock slip in and out of his ass, her breasts jiggling with each thrust. Then an odd look came across her pretty face. "Gonna come," she said, and her balls slapped up against his ass several times before pressing hard against him to release their load. The thought of a beautiful woman coming inside of him was too much for George, and he let go of his load just as the android collapsed on top of him. "Did you enjoy yourself?" asked a female voice. Except it wasn't Brisket, who was still panting from the workout. Looking up, George couldn't believe his eyes. "Oh my God! Dana!" gasped George as he saw his wife standing there. Brisket now withdrew her cock from him and stood up next to Dana. George was at a loss for words. "You passed my test," said Donna with the well-hung female android at her side. "Huh," said George, utterly confused. "I've never really been sure if you loved me," explained Anna. "So I came up with a plan to put you in a position, so to speak, where if you truly loved me, you'd have to suck cock and get fucked up the ass." George blushed, partly because he had fallen into the trap, and partly because it hadn't been entirely unenjoyable. Brisket was now cleaning herself up with tissues, and George marveled at the size of her cock and the thought that it had just been inside of him. Dana saw him watch Brisket and smiled wickedly at him. "So, do you want to keep her?" asked Dana. George blushed again, and Dana walked over to the android, who once again was standing patiently with her hands behind her back. "She could come in handy, don't you think?" said Donna as she felt up Brisket's cock and balls. Brisket's nipples hardened again, her chest began heaving, and she smiled. George smiled too. It looked like his marriage was saved, even if it meant a few heated moments of humiliation and strange pleasure. "I suppose she could," said George, who could never have guessed the adventure that he and his wife would soon embark upon.